What you're looking at is the first and only game that I ever made. I'm using game pretty loosely since it has no gameplay loop, no use for the money that you collect, and, well, it isn't very fun. This right here is the extent of my game development knowledge, and I want to change that. I recently found Godot while looking to get back into programming, and it reminded me of a childhood dream that I had to make my own game. So this is the start of a journey to make that dream a reality. To learn the kind of problem solving that goes into making a game. To better understand the different skills required to make that game fun. And to remember why I had that dream in the first place. This is going to take time. This is going to take patience, but I think this is something that the 7-year-old me would be proud of. And I think the 29-year-old me would be proud of it too. If you're ready, feel free to join me as we now have the green light to figure this out together. Let's look at my skills. For programming, the biggest thing that I ever programmed was a text-based time-tracking program for my friend. You could log your time a couple of different ways, view and edit your hours, and even change the text color. But I never used a game engine before. As for music production, I can play a little bit of piano, but I've never composed anything. And graphics. This is going to be a long process, and I'm going to mess up a lot, but if you're starting out too, maybe you can learn what not to do. And if you've been doing this for a while, I'm sorry. Alright, first thing, how do I take this and turn it into something better? Well, I think we need some kind of an enemy for starters, so let's just go ahead and... Well, I don't think anything screams don't touch this like a red X, so this'll do for now, but I need to make it work. I already gave it collision, but I couldn't get it to work as a character 2D. After some research, it looks like what I really need is an area 2D to send a signal when another body is entered. Done. Now let's get a game over screen going. I made a control node, saved it as a new scene, and wait, no. Saved it as a new scene and added a panel node because it looked like I could use it as a semi-transparent background. Now how do I call it? Give me a sec. Okay, wait, this is good. I can fix this. I have it as a child to the player scene, but if I add it as a child to the level scene... Perfect. Wait. Okay, now perfect, I think. Now let's make some text and add a button. Cool. Now to make the button restart the game. This shouldn't be that difficult except for the fact that the function that I use to pause the player's movement is actually pausing the entire game, so I can't click the button. It took me way too long to realize that. I changed the script attached to the player so it'll only accept inputs if it isn't dead, and voila, we can now restart. But for that to be useful, we need to add some challenge. Let's make the enemy chase you. After a lot of trial and error, a lot, this is the node structure that I came up with. It doesn't feel right, but it does work. I can move it with the move and slide function since it's a character 2D, and the area 2D node still works with the signal I had in place earlier. I just don't like that it's mad at me for not giving the character 2D a shape. Next, I want to increase the difficulty as the player collects more coins. We'll say after every fourth coin, a new enemy spawns. This was by far the longest I've been stuck yet. I couldn't figure out why the game kept crashing, and it was all because of this right here. The path to this node was breaking when the second enemy was spawned, but when I finally changed it, we have enemies. I think this is a good place to end it for now, but next time we probably need to update the enemy AI a bit. As a first-time user of this software and any game engine, this is like heaven for me. It's always going to be difficult learning something new, but the feeling of figuring it out is the greatest. I hope you'll continue to join me on this journey as we start to get more and more comfortable with Godot, and maybe we can start to get these skills up. Until next time, keep improving.